так вот у нас по расписанию выдавалось. Есть докладчик.
From Algeria, University of Tbilisi, Algeria.
Give you a short introduction about the SD-Shell nuclear and PSDPF interaction. The electromagnetic transition magnetic in SD-Shell nuclei will be presented as well as the results of the E2 and E3 transition, and I will finish by conclusion. The excitation energy spectra of the SD-Shell nuclei are characterized by the existence of a normal positive parity states, which are well studied in the SD model space using the well-known USD interaction or the more recent ones, USDA and USDB interactions, with an O16 core. In addition of these states, the experimental spectra show that there exists also a set of negative parity states, which are intruder states, resulting from the promotion of one nucleon from P to SD or from SD to PF shells. So to describe those states, we extended the model space from SD to the full PSDPF valence space, allowing one jump, which called one H bar omega space. We have thus developed an interaction compatible with this full PSDPF space, which called PSDPF interaction, using a helium-4 core. This interaction has been used to describe several excitation energy spectra and electromagnetic properties of mini nuclei and isotopic chains, which are published in these journals. And we have also collaborated with many international experimental groups to do PSDPF and calculations to explain their new experimental results for many nuclei and isotopic chains. Many of these results are published in these papers. I will show you two examples for the N equal 19 isotones. The first one concerns the silicon 33 nucleus, for which our PSDPF interaction reproduces very well the observed intruder negative parity states. The second one concerns the chlorine 36 isotopes, for which our PSDPF interaction describes perfectly all the observed sets of negative levels, even to high excitation energies. Note that here there is many states of for each spin and are well reproduced with our PSDPF interaction. So we have validated our interaction by calculating and compared the excitation energy spectra. Now, in the second step, we want to test our interaction for the calculation of electromagnetic transition properties in SD shell nuclei. So we know that the gamma transitions connecting positive parity states, which are M1 and E2, are well studied using the USDA and B Hamiltonians. For the gamma transition connecting negative parity states M1 and E2 and the ones connecting states with opposite parities M2, E3 and E1 and E3 can now be calculated using the PSDPF interaction, but it is very interesting to adjust their related parameters to known experimental data to get better results. We started with the study of the pure E2 transition connecting the first two class state to the ground state and E3 transition connecting the first three main state to the ground state in even SD nuclei. Note that in even SD nuclei, in general, the first states, exit states, are the power 2 plus and 3 minus states. We have calculated the E2 and E3 transition strengths using PSDPF interaction for the two transitions, which are a pure transition, using the free nucleon charges and compare them on these figures to experiment. We can see that the calculations is the calculations are very lower than experiment, so we need to use effective nucleon charges for the two transition and to adjust them to get or to improve the results. Before showing our results, I show you on this figure the excitation energies of the 2 plus and 3 minus states in even SD nuclei. So we can see that our PSDPF interaction will produce very well the excitation energies and the variation throughout the SD shell. Note here that for the doubly magic O16 and calcium 14 nuclei, the 2 plus states are observed at high energy, and we know that these two states are deformed and have four particle four hole configuration, and they can't be reproduced in our model space. So the effective charges for proton and neutron are given in by this formula and should be adjusted to minimize the root mean square deviations for E2 and E3 transitions. We have used different values for these nucleon charge, effective charges, to calculate the RMSD deviation. We show here the variation of the RMSD in function of the effective nucleon charges for the two types of transition, E2 and E3, and the minimum RMSD is obtained for these values for the E2 transition and for these values for the E3 transition. Here we calculated the RMSD for the E2 and E3 strands using the effective charges obtained in this work, and compared them with the RMS deviations calculated using all the effective charges obtained for the E2 transition connecting the positive parity states. We can see here also that the minimum of the RMSD are obtained using the new effective charges. We have used the new effective charges obtained in this work to calculate the strand, the E2 and E3 strands in even SD nuclei, and compared them to experimental data, known data. Here the calculation is in quite agreement with experiment for the strandness values or later for the strandness values or for the variation throughout the SD shell. So we can adopt this effective charges to calculate the E2 and E3, especially E3 transitions in SD nuclei. In conclusion, so we have developed a PSDPF interaction to describe simultaneously 0 and 1 H bar omega states throughout the SD shell. This interaction describes relatively well the excitation energies. To test this interaction, we used it to calculate the electromagnetic transition observables connecting states with the same and opposite qualities. To improve the results, it was necessary to fit the effective charges of the gamma transition connecting 2 plus and 0 plus, which is E2 transition, and the E3 transition connecting the 3 minus the ground state in even SD nuclei. This type of transition is a pure. New effective charges are obtained by minimizing the RMST strands for E2 and E3 transition. The obtained results are used to calculate the strands for even nuclei, and the results are in good agreement with the experiment. So it is now possible to calculate the E3 strand through the SD shell nuclei and confronted them to known data. And we hope in the near future examine the E1 strands using PSDPF interaction. Thank you for your attention.